I was one of the architects of the Campbell Inquiry. You know, there are points in our history where these inquiries are very important, and I think we're at a point where there's been a lot of development of the financial system since the Wallace Inquiry and since the Campbell Inquiry, which really requires an independent view of that. I'm not sure that I would have asked a climate-denying banker to do that, but we've got one, and you know, and I don't know how much he can think beyond his own experience and the role he played, say, in developing the Commonwealth Bank and broadening it into financial planning and asset funds management and so on. I mean, because those experience and trying to be global rather than just domestic. So their experiences haven't been very profitable for those banks. At least they haven't been very easy, very different cultures, and it's been very hard to manage that sort of process. So interesting to see what he says about that and how much he will recommend change, and whether, for example, the big four banks may start to divest their interests in funds management, their interest in financial planning after the experiences of Storm and less than adequate, you know, funds management performance, I guess. They might review their overseas operations, which haven't been a glowing success. I think from a consumer client type point of view, the thrust is we need more transparency. We're a very expensive market in Australia. Our costs of funds management, superannuation management is high by world standards. We need to look into that. That whole process of fee setting and performance is going to have to be opened up. And, you know, we've got FOFA rules and a whole lot of attempts to get at it, but there's still not enough transparency in the eyes of most people. They don't understand the risks that some of these institutions are taking and how they manage them. So there are a lot of issues there.